So we changed models once again. We've got no shortage of healthy athletic PTs. This is Siri Berg, PT. Thanks again for the help. She's going to help us demonstrate both the way we can use this to do some plyometrics as well as some eccentric loading for the lower body. A couple things to point out while we were off screen. We took away that shim out from under the base of the shuttle recovery. What that does is it changes the angle just slightly. Still very comfortable for the patient. Obviously, you can't do that while the patient is on, but it's a pretty easy one-person technique, too, if you're really watching your ergonomics. What that means is that now we can have all the elastic resistance, but we can also get that inclined plane, so it's a great way for your athletes to really load things up, or if we want to work some eccentrics. So what we're going to do now as well, come back over here, and I can decide to add as many of these black cords that, again, are roughly 25 pounds resistance. We can load this up as much as you want. We'll put all four on in this case. There's been plenty of research that shows if we wanted to pick one exercise modality as far as remodeling tissue that is in a tendinosis state. So again, not that tendinitis don't exist. There's just a wealth of research saying a lot of our chronic overuse tendon injuries may start as a tendinitis, but then develop histologically into a tendinosis where they're not necessarily acutely inflamed. There's changes in the collagen matrix of the tissue, and they really need to be stimulated to be remodeled. Eccentric means working a muscle through the down phase or sort of the deceleration stroke of an exercise, and there's good research that can really promote or accelerate that tissue remodeling. We see this all the time in Achilles tendinosis, patellar tendinosis, as well as several other sites. It's definitely thought to be some of the problem with rotator cuff pathology as well. So there's some protocols we've always used, but again, with this is you can control a lot of things. You can stabilize the core artificially in a plinth. You can start things earlier than you would otherwise to make sure they're biomechanically aligned. This has quite a bit of resistance. So Siri, when you're ready, just give us a standard double leg squat up. And that's pretty sturdy, I'm guessing. That's a lot of load, but believe it or not, with eccentrics, you're trying to overload things. So what we can do is if we load two up, and this will be a challenge for you when you're ready, on the downstroke, I only want you to use this leg to work. You can leave that one up, or if she's confident enough, pull it down. So the protocol of two legs up, one leg down lets you dramatically overload in only the eccentric cycle. So again, two legs up, concentric phase of muscle action, two legs down, eccentric. This is essentially a tonic or a stimulation to improve the histology of that patellar tendon. We could do that for the Achilles as well. So on this next one, Siri, when you're ready, I want you to come up to not just a squat, but a calf raise. Same thing, shift your weight to the left, just recover that part, put your foot back. Two legs up for concentric phase of muscle action. One leg down is going to eccentrically stimulate that Achilles tendon to remodel. Good. Good. All right, go ahead and recoil, Siri, and relax. So welcome back. We're going to show an alternate way to do eccentric loading on the lower body tendons with our subject, Siri Berg, PT, here. So some patients might have a little trouble coordinating the previous model we showed of two legs up, one leg down. Most really do, but if you get someone who's having a lot of trouble or is a very concrete thinker, we can do it in an alternate way, too. So when you're ready, Siri, just leave two legs up there, and I want you to give me a simple two-leg squat up. Now, right now, she's only working against a simple 12-pound elastic cord, but now that she's up, go ahead and stay there for a little, Siri. If I want to load her up sequentially, I can throw on that load and really tank that up and say, okay, Siri, now you're going to feel a lot more resistance, but all you have to do is just return slowly to where you started. Okay, now that might be a lot of changing of cords here, but again, while I'd recommend the other protocol first, so two legs up, one leg down, for some patients, even if it required a lot of switching for you, if this gets them to the desired goal of being able to eccentrically load that tissue, I guess the means justify the end, and it's not too bad for you as a therapist.
All right, so one other way that we use this and we like to look for with this plyometric eccentric kind of combination is cueing the patient just to use that auditory cue or listening to the impact on that and just cueing for a really light, soft impact. So go ahead and try a couple of those, Amy, just kind of trying first not to control it. Just go ahead and just come down with a poorly controlled one. And hopefully you can hear there's a pretty loud slap happening in there. So go ahead now, and we're really going to have you use all those muscles through there to really absorb the shock and control it. Nice, soft landing. So a lot of times, again, using that auditory cue for a nice soft landing to help absorb the shock and train those tissues to handle that.